Hello everyone, I'd like to show you a tool that I have made. It's called Elm Bench, and it tries to make benchmarking Elm code faster or easier than you know, in the usual process where you have to create a new like Elm like project, you know, import all the benchmarking tools in there. Change the source directories to like point to the code that you want to test and so on. Just like a lot of hassle, and so I want to make this easier to do. So let's see it in action. So I have an example here with the remove function. So this is like for, you know, list extra remove or something like that. And so Elm Bench needs each of the versions of your code to have a main module with this function that you will be testing exposed. So I have that in both cases here. And so let's run it. Elm Bench. So let's see what is the usage. So versions, right? So Elm Bench v old v new. And now for the function name, let's remove. And let's try remove 42 from list range of like 1,000 items or so. And let's run it. And you can see, you know, my CPU is spinning, so it's doing something. And we've got some results. So the old version, you know, runs in this many nanoseconds per function invocation. And the new one is faster. I could, you know, quickly experiment with a shorter list, you know, smaller data, and you could just like scale things and see how it behaves. And yeah, we've got some results. It's, you know, still faster, so that's good. So that's one example, but this one was pretty simple, right? Because there was just like one function, there was no like importing other modules and so on. So I have another example here with my package priority queue, and you know, you can see that there are like two modules that like depend on like the underlying implementation. So this is a little bit more involved. And so how my main function in here looks is I have a scenario and I'm importing from, you know, the priority queue. And in this, inside this scenario, I am, you know, doing some work, and I just want to measure how much that work takes. So, okay, that's that. Let's maybe make it a little bit smaller. Let's do the same thing in the other one. And yeah, we can try to run it. So Elm Bench, V110, V111. Actually, let's put the version here. And now scenario, right? And so there's a little gotcha with benchmarks. You have to put things in like a function always. So if you don't, so if I had just like scenario equals, that would make things, you know, run when the application starts. And that's no good because it would pre-compute the value and there would be nothing to benchmark. So Elm Bench tells us that. So, you know, this will make the benchmark meaningless, make the function scenario take an argument. Okay, so I have done that. So let's put the argument here as well. And off we go. And so again, this tests both versions that I have provided. It runs the function that I have specified here on the command line, and it just benchmarks both of them. Okay, and we can see, okay, the old version takes, you know, this many nanoseconds, and the new one is faster. And so we can see that this is a benchmark that Jeroen has made for his optimizations of my code. So, you know, there are some specifics of like how the JavaScript virtual machine handles what Elm compiler generates. And so it's like, if you want to make your code as fast as possible, you need to know these, like, JavaScript V8 specifics. And so Yeru knows those. He's very good about optimizing Elm code, and so he knows to, like, pad the constructors to have the same length, and that somehow makes it faster. And we can see that's true. The new code is, 20% faster. So those were my two little examples of how to use ElmBench, and I hope you like it. I hope you like, faster feedback loops, and that was really the goal with ElmBench, to just let you experiment more quickly, let you iterate more quickly, and do stuff from the command line instead of having to run in the browser. So yeah, see you next time.